kyerɛ baako a ɔmampanyin adodan kwaku fuado ɔbae no ɔne n'aban adidi dwuma paa na mane bae to dwa ɛne sɛ ghana beyond aid nhyehyɛ ne ho ayɛ akɔnɔ ɛkyerɛ nkyɛ nam ɛnti united nations development program for aso
United Nations Development Program in Kasahua, a Bibrema mine penny for so can who be a call so a one crying. Ya, it's ya net de jumedina so, a Africa's money for African development, a future beyond aid. Na en yenimu kasanimu, ena mampenina na to tankwa e kufuado, what did you just say? Ghana beyond aid in shesheno e ya dia, e dana kuma ponosopa.
When I talk of Ghana or Africa beyond aid, therefore, I'm simply insisting. We use our resources to build robust economies that will propel us into the ranks of the developed nations of the world. I'm insisting that we stop believing that our deliverance will come from benefactors. I'm insisting that we take our fate in our own hands and work to bring us to where we do not look for or expect charity. I'm insisting that we would only become truly independent when we are economically independent. This is not an unrealistic aspiration. Our first priority must be to change the structures of the economies on the continent, which are dependent largely on the production and export of raw materials. It is this reliance on raw material exports that feeds our dependence on foreign aid and subjects us to the politics of external powers. We cannot be doing the same thing over and over again and expect a different result. We do not have to accept someone's definition of Africa or Ghana. We must define and craft our own destiny. The good thing is that it has been done before. We can and must learn from others, and we should chart our own course and change the African narrative. Africa, I am confident, will be a wealthy and dynamic member of the global community, making her own unique contribution to the growth of world civilization. May God bless Mother Africa and us all. And I thank you for your attention.